In this tutorial, you will learn how to import an object, define a load and a rigging, and rig the load to the hook of your crane. We want to rig a load object to the machine. Let's select the hook and open the context menu. Select Rig Object and click on Add New Rigging and Add New Load Object. Now we have to define the mass. Let's choose a 25 tons. The utilization of the machine is now increased to about 90%. After you rig the load to your hook, you can see the hierarchy of the objects in the object panel. The first object is the crane, followed by the hook, the rigging and the load. Whenever you move the crane, everything that is attached will follow. When you move the hook, the rigging and the load will follow. Another way to attach a load to the hook is to select a primitive object from the library. Therefore, open the menu object and select Primitive and Box. Let's scale the box to a concrete block in the scene. If you want, you can define the size in the parameter panel. Now rename the object to Concrete Plate and select the context menu and define the load object with a mass of 22 tons. Select the hook and choose Rig Object and Add New Rigging. Let's edit the rigging in the rigging editor. Therefore, you have to select Rigging and Rigging Editor. Now choose the two-rope rigging on the right side and change the position of the upper sling to the edge of the concrete block. Crane Planner calculates the forces in all rigging components. Select one of the bottom ropes and open the Dimension tab and activate the force resolution on the right side. The applied forces of the rope are indicated in the scene of the rigging editor. A third way to import a load object into the scene is to select the complex object from the library. Select the menu object, open the library, and select the load object. And load the tank to the scene. Select the hook and choose Add New Rigging and the tank. Now select the rigging, open the context menu, and enter the rigging editor. Select a four-rope traverse. And let's scale the traverse length to a total length of 6 meters. You can either scale the traverse in the scene or define a numeric number in the parameter panel. Now let's change the position of the bottom rope attachment point at the traverse and connect the lower attachment points to the load object. As you see, all actions in the rigging definition are automatically synchronized on the other sides as well. This is because all rigging templates in Crane Planner are symmetric to the center of gravity. The forces and angles within the rigging are recalculated every time you move an item. In this tutorial, we learned how to rig a load to the hook and how to use the rigging editor. In the next tutorial, you will get familiar with the project overview.